It will not get us there, brother. It will not get us there, sister. As long as we don't have the God kind of love that is kind, patient. If your love, or what you call love, is impatient, is not kind, it envies, it parades itself, is puffed up, it behaves rudely, it seeks its own, is provoked easily, so sensitive, thinks evil and rejoices in iniquity, does not rejoice in the truth, it does not bear all things, it does not believe all things, it does not hope all things, it does not endure all things, it fails. That's not the kind of love, that's not the kind of the love of God that is required of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. He says, pursue love. 1 Corinthians 14. Pursue love and desire spiritual gifts, but especially that you may prophesy. Hallelujah. And then it goes on to say, you can have, he says, for now we see in the mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know just as I also am known. And now abide faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of all is love. Love leads. It's love is what makes all the difference. Love is what differentiates you, that distinguishes you. It sets you apart. You know, it's something that needs to be cultivated. In order for you to remain in love, you got to dwell in God. I know it from me. When I'm irritated by just life generally, by things, when I get into the presence of God, even the most person that has annoyed me, suddenly I ooze love for them. I begin to want to give them gifts. I want to, you know, do good for them. This is when you know that the love of God that is shared abroad our hearts by the Holy Spirit, it makes all the difference. Hallelujah. So, you know, when I give you an opportunity to come to the knowledge of the one that I was talking about here, the one who has love on the inside of him, the one who is on the inside of us. If you have him on the inside of you, this is why, you know, remember he told us in John chapter 4, hallelujah. He says in John chapter 4, there will come a time that we will no longer need to be in places to worship God, but God will require those who will worship him in spirit and in truth. And worshiping God in spirit and in truth, you've got to be in the spirit in order to have the ability to worship in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah, glory to God. So I want to give you an opportunity so that, you know, you come to an understanding of what I talk about here the most and actually apply what I talk about here. Glory to God. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you've never really even heard what I talk about, or you've never heard the name of Jesus. Remember, I'll give you a quick testimony about myself. A few years ago, well, when I got born again, I wanted to try Jesus because I had heard about Jesus, but I didn't think that's the same Jesus that was going to change my life so drastically, because the name was used in vain. You know, in the area where I grew up, people, they would just call the name of the Lord in vain. So I didn't take that Jesus seriously. So I wondered, when I got felt like it was time for me to be born again, I said I needed to go and try the Jesus that would bring me all the, you know, the righteousness. That was not the intention for getting saved, but I was really trying Jesus. I wanted to try a different Jesus. And then I tried the different Jesus, and that Jesus who is love, then I found him. So you may have heard about Jesus maybe through your siblings, or through your schoolmates, or your workmates, or whatever the case, but I want you to try the Jesus that I tried, because he's the one who makes all the difference in my life. And receiving him, it helps you to be authentically the child of God. It helps you to be authentically the child of God, because not everyone is the child of God as long as you have not received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Because the Bible says in the book of John chapter 1 verse 12, those who received him, his son Jesus Christ, the anointed one, they were given the power to be the children of God. So what that implies is that not everyone is the child of God. So in order for you to be authentically the child of God and partake in that which God says is yours, you must be his child authentically. Hallelujah. So in less than a couple of minutes, I'm going to ask that you pray the prayer with your lips out loud, because receiving Jesus says those who he says, when you confess with your mouth and believe with your heart, you shall be saved. Confessing that Jesus Christ is Lord and believing in your heart that God raised him from the dead, this is the getting born again. This is the being given birth to by the Spirit. Remember, it says you must be born again, be born of water and born of the Spirit. You will not enter the kingdom of heaven. You will not see the kingdom of heaven if you are not born again, born of water and born of the Spirit. This means being baptized, confession with your mouth, and also being baptized with the Spirit of God. So being born again, you receive the Spirit of God and you get born again. And the Bible says you shall be saved. So through the confession, in less than a couple of minutes, I'm going to ask that you confess with your mouth, with your lips out loud and your heart open. The Bible says you shall be saved. For it is unto confession you are saved. It is unto believing you are made righteous. So in less than a minute, I'm going to ask that you pray. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe you are the Son of God. God sent you to die for me. I believe he raised you up on the third day. I believe you're coming back again for me. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me by the blood of Jesus. From today, I am saved. I am born again. I am forgiven. I will go to heaven because Jesus Christ is my Lord. Help me, Father, to obey your commandments. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Heaven rejoices over just one person coming to the knowledge of the Lord Jesus. If you pray that prayer by faith, the Bible says your sins are forgiven. Always remember to go to God if anything is happening in your life. And never run away from him, because if you try to go back, it's like going back to the devil. The devil comes to kill, steal, and to destroy. But Jesus came to give you life and life more abundantly. So stick to the one who came to give you life. He says, I call heaven and earth as a witness against you today. I set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Choose life. So that's the life that you've just chosen now. Chosen the eternal life. Jesus himself is life. Being in Christ is the real life to live. And I'm going to ask you that you lift up your hands to the one you've just prayed to now, you've received, and let him feed you with his Spirit. Father, I pray that you will fill my brother, Father, my sister with your Spirit, Father, that they will walk in righteousness. They will be witnesses, God, in the name of Jesus, for you've called us to make disciples. Almighty God, Father, touch them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. You pray that prayer, you're forgiven, you're born again. Now begin to read the Bible. Find a Bible believing church, a church that teaches the Bible, and begin to study the word. Because loving God is obeying God. Obeying God is all, the commandments of God are all in his word. You'll get to know what he likes, what he does not like when you study the word of God. You study to show yourself approved unto God, not unto man. It's all about, getting to know God, basically, because everything that he is all in his word. Hallelujah. And then you also know how to witness when you study the word as well. God bless you so much. And I will see you soon. Hallelujah.